When we talk about climate change and hurricane season in Florida, we tend to focus on extremes.
Tonight, Hurricane Irma monster storm as Irma slams into Tampa. Fears of a huge storm surge.
Hurricane Dorian nearly as wide as Ohio. The entire state in the danger zone.
This is not about doomsday scenarios. It's about the game of inches residents may not realize they're playing.
For Eta, we had no idea. It was a tropical storm. Nobody was really talking about it a whole lot. It caught us totally by surprise.
In the garage as well.
I will.
At the end of the day, it was probably only 2 or 3 inches inside the house. So thank goodness, it could have been a lot worse. But even the 2 or 3 inches, it was probably between 75 and 100,000 for 2 to 3 inches of water. And I don't even know if that includes the cars. So it was shocking, shocking.
Tropical Storm Eta affected thousands of properties in Tampa Bay. It caused millions of dollars in damage, most of it out of sight.
We had to rip carpet out of the rooms, tear off obviously all the baseboards and the door trim and the doors and the closet doors and the bottom 2 to 4 feet of all of the drywall. I think that was one of the first things we noticed, is just everybody hauling everything out of their houses, piling up on the side of the road, and then all the tow trucks coming to get the cars.
Eta's approach and wind pushed surge directly up into the bay at a time when water levels were already higher than normal.
Any coastline is prone to storm surge. And unfortunately, Tampa Bay is one of the most at-risk areas, as is most areas along the Gulf Coast. It doesn't take much wind to really drive water up and over the land, certainly within Tampa Bay.
To find out what that means for homeowners and the region's future, Times data reporter Langston Taylor worked with the National Hurricane Center to model and analyze flooding from Eta.
Hey, Cody, how you doing?
Good, man. How you doing?
Good.
The partnership was a one-of-a-kind use of the Hurricane Center's storm models to illustrate Tampa Bay's risk.
If you think about Florida and the peninsula on its own, what makes the east coast of Florida different from the west coast is how the ocean floor slopes down beneath the water level. So on the west coast of Florida and primarily along the Gulf Coast, the shelf is very shallow.
That impacts both the height and just how far inland it'll go?
Yeah, more or less. Yeah, certainly the height of the water level and how much that water might extend inland. The Gulf Coast is very susceptible to storm surge. And we've seen that many times over. And even certain tropical storms that impact the Gulf Coast can produce, you know, at least life-threatening surge. If you reference Eta, it drove that wind like right into the bay and produced, you know, at least I think a little more than 3 feet in many parts of that area.
Water levels when Eta hit were higher than average by nearly a foot.
The tide is well up, probably about 10 feet over the seawall.
That makes the storm an opportunity to examine how climate change will continue to impact the region. An extra foot is in line with sea level rise projections for 2050, or the last year of a 30-year mortgage signed in 2020.
In practical terms, people live there. What does that mean in terms of risk for those people who wouldn't be at risk with lower water?
It will make worse the overall hazards that are associated with hurricanes, primarily storm surge. You're going to increase not only the storm surge based on its height, but it will move further inland, and it will affect areas, even residents that may have not been impacted before. No, you're not going to stop the water from impacting the land. I mean, that's just not going to happen. So there is going to be that risk.
Christine has lived in her St. Petersburg home for 7 years. Before Eta, water had never breached the entryways.
Came through all three entrance points at the same time, the front door, the garage door, and the back door.
In the future, the same storm could flood 5 times as many properties, depending on how quickly seas rise. When Hurricane Elsa looked to be on a similar track, Christine and her husband weren't taking any chances.
These are new. We just got these 3 weeks ago. And we hope they work. None of this happened last time. This morning at 6 a.m., it looked like a living room. Have the generator in the shop back, out of the garage. We're almost guaranteed water will be in the garage this time. And we hope that we don't have to use any of this, but I'd rather clean this all up than clean up a flood. I don't know how, if we're gonna do this for every single storm that comes from now on, but I don't wanna go through that again.
Fortunately, Elsa ended up being another near miss. For those flooded, like Christine, Eta was a wake-up call. But many of Tampa Bay's 3 million residents have never lived through something like that before. At least not yet.